most network marketing, most MLM companies are traditional business opportunity first. Hey, it's Lance McGowan here, and I am reacting to another Reddit post here today, and this one is titled, "Ever since I graduated, I've been getting Facebook messaged and Instagram DMs from Huns." Dun dun dun. Alright, so Huns are basically people in the MLM business that may be a little bit, you know, aggressive, or just people that promote their own companies. There's probably a better definition of it, but that's the context I'm understanding it here. And so you have Martin Luther Bling. That sounds like a really interesting name. And the handle is Fa2Chainz. Okay, all right. Well, says the worst Facebook messages are, and then he gives an example. Hey girl, and they give an example. Hey girl, long time no talk. Congrats on graduating. That's awesome. But if you want to make money from home and be your own boss, and then there's like a little dash right there, so you can kind of see. And then they say, stop right there. I did not spend 4 years in college to join a pyramid scheme. And so there's, you know, a number of retweets, likes, and then they, obviously this got reposted in Reddit, and there's, you know, some comments here. And basically, you know, this is, I would say, obviously they've had a bad experience. Somebody is following more of a traditional network marketing model of just selling and recruiting, and that's what most MLM or network marketing companies follow from a company culture standpoint. I would say a very small percent actually follow an authentic network marketing model where it's focused on teaching and sharing and leading with powerful products, not leading with the business opportunity. And so you notice in here, in this statement of basically, but if you want to make money from home and be your own boss, you notice how that's a, they're basically telling the prospect something instead of seeking understanding. And Eric Worre talks a lot about this. He says the only time you should give a hard sell or a direct basically approach to the business opportunity is one, if you know the person really well, not just know them well, but know them really well, and you know they're looking for a business opportunity, or they're looking to diversify their income. If those two things aren't mentioned, because I don't know about you, but after reading that, I don't think that it, I don't get the impression that either they knew them really well or that they knew that they were looking for to, you know, diversify their income or business opportunity. So clearly that's not the case, right? At least they're not looking for the, they don't have a need, or they're not looking for the business opportunity side. And then, you know, the second part here is, you know, I didn't spend 4 years in college to join a pyramid scheme. Okay, that's funny because I went to Ohio State, a graduated marketing transportation major in 2008. Flashback. Anyways, fast forward. So I worked for PepsiCo for 7 years, did the whole corporate thing. It just felt like it was more about profits over people, more about the numbers than nurturing relationships. Although I did gain a lot of valuable people management, process management, project management skills, it was great. I just didn't see myself doing it long term. I just wasn't passionate about it. I mean, just to be blunt and honest. But I did know that I did want to work with people that I chose more so. I did want to work with more moms and more women. That was definitely something I was drawn to because of my own mom and her experiences with her health and wanting to help her, but her not being as open. And so me wanting to work with moms who were more open, that was definitely a part of my story and my journey. And also being able to focus more on the marketing side of things and the health side of things was really passionate about. And so, you know, I went to a green smoothie class, and then I went to a essential oil class, and the rest is history. I just connected with people I knew, liked, and trust, and felt like I was going to get some really good, valuable education on the whole food side, primarily, and then the essential oil side, and I was like, wow, this is great. I got the best of both worlds. I got what I eat and what I can use to supplement with my health and be independent with my health, and great, awesomeness. And so my point of saying that little, you know, story there is that I didn't go to school to be a network marketer, a professional network marketer, but that is what I am now, and it is one of the best decisions I've made, because ultimately when you do network marketing as a professional, not as an amateur, not as a novice, but when you say, I'm going to do this professionally, whether it be part-time, full-time, side hustle, whatever you want to call it, but when you say, I'm going to do this professionally, you know, I'm going to be a lawyer and a network marketing professional, or I'm going to be a doctor and a network marketing professional, or I'm going to be a teacher and a network marketing professional, whatever you say, and network marketing professional, you're saying basically, I'm going to be focused on, you know, adding value to people and basically talking to a lot of people, educating them, and really matching a need with a solution or a problem with a solution through a word of mouth or referral-based marketing system, which is arguably the most oldest and effective way to share and purchase things, which is word of mouth. And so it's not a pyramid scheme. When there's products exchange for money, that is legal. The FTC defines that as legal. That's perfectly fine. It's when money is exchanged for headcount or money is exchanged for recruiting. That's illegal. And I wouldn't be a part of anything illegal. And so that is really important. And as you can see, this is just not mentioning any companies. This isn't mentioning anything in general. But it's still important because some people still have, and there is, you know, a negative connotation to network marketing and pyramid schemes and MLMs. And I think when people do that, they just either had a bad experience themselves as a customer or distributor, or they're just operating out of ignorance and strong predisposition against MLMs, network marketing companies, essential oil companies, whatever it is, you know. And that to me means they either are open to the truth or they're not. And if they're not, I keep it moving, talk to the next person. I move towards the people that move towards me. I don't try to stick a square peg through a circle hole. I just, you know, move on, right? And so maybe, you know, I usually take no as not now, and maybe I may revisit it if I get a good vibe from them. But if not, I just move towards the people that are just more open and more ready to learn about natural solutions and all types of stuff. It's unfortunate that people feel the need to kind of leave this, but it's also unfortunate when people maybe don't have the right training to and lead with the business opportunity and recruiting and selling over powerful products, teaching and sharing. But that's just the nature of how things work, because again, most network marketing, most MLM companies are traditional business opportunity first, right? Ferraris, mansions type of language. Not always that specifically, but something like that. Versus what I'm a part of, which is more teaching and sharing, leading with products. All right, well, that's it for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to hit the like button if you did. Make sure to hit subscribe for future video updates. And most importantly, check out the links in the description below so you can read the rest of this post, check out some of the comments, or just continue to get your learn on with the other videos that I have. And other than that, we'll see you in the next video.